Welcome to Good Libations, which is our program about mixology. And of course, we've been discussing winter drinks and the appropriateness of certain drinks to serve during this season with our parties. But of course, keep in mind, there's two hemispheres on this earth. We are in winter right now, but the southern hemisphere is not. In fact, their spring, summer is right during our autumn, winter. And we've been talking a great deal lately about the use of cachaça, which is the spirit of Brazil, and which is totally neglected practically completely in this country. Many people don't even know what cachaça is. They call it cachaca and all kinds of other things, but it is cachaça. You can see that little cedilla on the last C. And it is a wonderful, worthy spirit. It is actually distilled from sugarcane juice, unlike rum, which is distilled from actually molasses. So the flavor of it is entirely different from rum. In fact, I find it more akin to tequila with, funny enough, overtones of scotch and, of all things, champagne, flat champagne. But it's unique, and personally, I love it. So we're going to endeavor to make a cocktail that is suitable for serving at your winter and fall parties and events, utilizing cachaça. And this particular brand is not an expensive brand, but it's really good. I would put it up against any particular brand of cachaça, even the really expensive ones. It's truly good. A lot of complexity, a lot of flavor, and it is aged in a barrel. And you can really tell. At any rate, I'm going to go ahead and use the shaker only as a medium to basically do things with the drink. But before we do that, I'm actually going to muddle some blueberries in, of all things, elderflower liqueur, which is a unique substance in of itself that I've used before in some of the programs. So I'm going to put a few blueberries in here, and I'm going to put in the elderflower liqueur, and then I'm going to muddle it before we do anything else with this drink here. And muddling doesn't mean that you pulverize the fruit, it just means that you bruise it enough so that some of the characteristic of it is going to come out in the cocktail. And we don't want to use too much elderflower liqueur. Elderflower liqueur is pretty potent smell-wise and taste-wise, so we don't want to use too much. So I'm going to go ahead and try to bruise this up a little bit here, but not ridiculously so. And sometimes if you try to hit each one of whatever fruit that you're muddling once or twice, that's enough to get the flavor out of it and also to get the liquor in it. And this makes a really nice drink. And these are ingredients that people would not normally put with cachaça, but makes a really good drink, indisputably. So now, for this particular part of it, I'm going to add some ice to the shaker. And again, I'm making sample-sized drinks, not big, humongous drinks. So I'm going to get it nice and cold, but not ridiculously so. And in the shaker, I'm going to put the cachaça, enough to make a sample. And cachaça is pretty potent. It has a taste and a flavor that could overwhelm the other ingredients if you put too much of it in. And the other ingredient that I'm going to use liquor-wise, and I would have actually have preferred to use orange curacao, but I'm going to use triple sec. But orange curacao would be my first choice. And we're going to put a little bit of it in there, but not a lot. Because again, we want other flavors to stand out too. And then I'm going to cut a bit of the small orange here and squeeze it in the shaker. And again, make sure that when you squeeze your fruit that you do hand squeezing, because you want the infusion and the oil from the peel to get in the drink. And if you use a juicer, you're not going to get that. So hand squeeze your fruit. And I left the spent shell in there too, because that again will impart even more of the flavor into the liquor. So at this particular point, we're gonna go ahead and shake it. Only a couple of times. And unfortunately, I have a block of ice in here, which is too bad, but now I guess I can't do that. I'm gonna have to chop this up a bit. And always remember that you're gonna have little glitches when you make drinks. So when things like this happen, don't freak out. Just handle it and then do it. So I broke up the ice. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in here with the blueberry and the orange and everything and the elderflower liqueur. And I'm gonna give it a little bit of a stir just to make sure that everything is there, blended properly. And then I'm gonna give it a taste to see if it lives up to the hype and if this turned out good. And oh yes, I would have to say that is outstanding. You can taste the hint of the elderflower liqueur. You can taste the hint of the orange liqueur. And again, the note up front is the cachaça, which is exactly what we want. We don't want that to fade into the background and get lost. So it's there and it's noticeable. And this really is a lovely drink. This is something that is very worthy of anybody's party. So give it a try. In fact, try to make the other drinks that I introduced Good Libations listeners and viewers to that incorporated cachaça, going beyond the caprina, which is the most popular drink that's made with cachaça. Give them a try because they're really different, they're really unique. You will impress people, and you're serving them something different that they probably have never had before. Unless really they've been to Brazil or to other parts of South America. So enjoy, celebrate, and widen out your palate and widen out your mind in what you do. And again, my name is Ethel Andrews. This is Good Libations, our program about mixology. And always be careful with your consumption and the responsibility that you show when you host parties and when you attend parties that involve alcohol. Thank you for tuning in and enjoy. Bye-bye.